We like to watch TV while we eat dinner. We often use these plastic trays. They're very flimsy and they're pretty ugly and they look like something from a school cafeteria. I decided that we should have something made of wood or bamboo or something like that. And I started pricing them out and they're like $25, $30 a piece. So I decided just to make my own. And this one I made today cost me about $6 to make this tray. And it's made out of real wood. It's made out of birch with an aluminum channel around the outside. And it took me about 20 minutes to make. So let me show you how to do it. This is a job that does not have to be hard. It really involves only two materials. You've got veneer board. Veneer board is plywood, basically. You can see on the inside, just plain old furniture grade plywood. And on the outside is a factory applied veneer, such as maple. Maple on the top, maple on the bottom. This is unfinished, so it would have to be finished. And here's another kind. This is birch, also plywood on the inside, and birch on the top, birch on the bottom. The difference is you can see a little gloss here. This has been finished, so there's not much for me to do after the tray has been constructed. The other thing is this stuff called channel aluminum, and the wood is half inch thick, and you're also going to get half inch channel. And you can see it just really nicely fits in there. Perfectly fits, like that. And that's the way it's going to work. You can decide on the size that you want. I'm using this plastic tray as a reference point. We found this to be a little too small. So we're going to make this 20 inches wide to start with. We'll make that our first cut. So first of all, I'll cut off a little piece of this channel to use as a reference point. And you can use a piece of scrap wood to hold it while you cut. So the way we're going to do this is, instead of cutting these corners at 45 degree angles, we're going to bring them up like this. So instead of this one coming to the very edge of the wood, it's going to come out further, and this is going to hit the bottom. This is too far. I'm just bringing it out this far right now to show you that there is a depression. Let's push that back. Okay. So that's the true look of it. It's going to have this little depression, which is we're going to fill in later on. It's time to measure out the side pieces. So now you can see that they all fit together, and what you want to do is take each piece and just lightly sand them down. You could use any kind of sandpaper for this because you're not doing a lot of sanding, just trying to get rid of the burrs from this. Pretty much anything will work. So for the end pieces, you can use all sorts of things to fill in that depression. You can use hot glue. So one thing you can do if the hot glue just doesn't have the kind of shape you want, you can take a heat gun, or I suppose a hairdryer would also work, and just give it a little heat, not too much.